Today I'm headed over to the UPS store to drop off a package. I'm on my 2010 Curry Echo Drive E-Zip. It's an old version of an e-bike. Not even sure what kind of motor it's called. It's kind of an external chain drive on the rear wheel. I'll show you that in a minute. It's definitely not as easy to pedal around as the Eohora Juliet. Of course, that 1,000 watt motor means a lot more than this little 250 watt one. Hello. Hello. Stop over here a minute. So this is the Curry. It is from 2010, so it's fairly old. This one was made in America. The newer versions were made in China. This is the kind of motor, not sure what it's called. It's a 250 watt, and then it has PAS and throttle. So that's kind of nice, taking off from stop signs and stop lights. But anyways, let's get going. Surprisingly enough, I'm on the original battery. I have damaged the battery casing and then the controls, so I've got them separate, and that's why they're in the pannier bags. This bicycle has considerably less tire noise. I mean, part of it's the city tires, as well as being considerably skinnier. Knobby tires on the Juliet, they make a lot of road noise, so. I wasn't riding with pedal assist. Now I am. So I believe the pedal assist on this one cuts out at like 13 or 14 miles an hour. I'm not sure. Hello? So we're back on today on the Midland Trace Trail. This one runs parallel to Highway 32 in Indiana. And we are in Westfield still. I really need to adjust the gear shift mechanism. When this engine kicks in, or the motor kicks in, it sounds kind of like a brake pad dragging. I remember when I first got it, people weren't used to e-bikes at all, so the noise would be coming down the trail and people be looking weird at you. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the camera here because I'm not sure how many people want to be filmed while they're headed to lunch.